Hello viewer, welcome to Elimu TV, where you watch and learn. Welcome to the 10th lesson of biology, where we're going to learn today about the cell structure. I am your teacher, Madam Christine Okoth. Welcome. Let us have a preview of what you're going to learn today in this lesson. First, we're going to review the previous lesson and the assignment that I gave you. Then we're going to look at the cell structure and functions of the cell structure under a light microscope and an electron microscope. And lastly, I'm going to give you an assignment. So starting with the assignment, question number one was, an object has been magnified 275 times. The objective lens is 25. So you're supposed to calculate the eyepiece lens. So how do you calculate the eyepiece lens? It will be the total magnification divided by the objective lens. So in this case, you're supposed to take 275, then you divide it by 25, and you do that simple math, you're going to get 11. So the eyepiece lens is 11, and remember you have to write the time sign to show that it has been magnified 11 times. Then question number two, calculate the actual size of a specimen. The specimen has been magnified 72 times and the image size is 12 centimeters. So for you to get the actual size of this specimen, you're supposed to take the image size divided by magnification. So in this case, we take 12 divided by 72 and you end up finding 0.17 centimeter. So the actual size of this specimen is 0.17 centimeter. Then when it has been drawn, the image, the thing that you draw, the piece of paper, that is what we call the image size, is 12 centimeters. So back to the business of the day today on the cell structures. When you put a specimen of a plant under a light microscope, that is what you will see on the light microscope. That is the structure of the plant cell under a light microscope. Then when you come to the actual drawing, this is just a rough sketch of what is a plant cell looks like. So we have a cell wall. Then we have another membrane we call the cell wall. We have a cell membrane, then we have a cell wall. Then inside the cell, we have a cytoplasm. We have the nuclei, the visible part there, the purple structure there. Then we have a vacuole. We're going to look at some of the functions of these structures. And lastly, when you look at a plant cell, you observe something we call a chloroplast. So those are the features that you see when you look at a plant under a light microscope. Proceeding to the animal cell. So when you take a cell of an animal, you place it under a light microscope, that is what you will see. Then when it comes to the drawing, just a rough sketch of how an animal cell looks like under a light microscope. So those are some of the features that you find on the animal cell. First, we have the nuclei, that bluish part over there. Then we have the cytoplasm and we have the cell membrane. When you do a comparison between the plant cell and animal cell, you'll observe there are some things which are common and some things which are just found only on the plant cell. For example, both of them, so that is both the animal cell and the plant cell, they have this outer membrane we call the cell membrane. Then both of them have this cytoplasm and all of them have the nucleus. Now, when you come to the plant, it has additional structures. For example, the chloroplast is only found in plant because this is because it is the one which is responsible for the process of photosynthesis. That's why we say that the plants are autotrophs, because they can be in position to synthesize their own food. Whereas the animals are heterotrophs because they do not have that green pigment we call the chlorophyll. Therefore, they depend on plants and other organisms. Then we have the vacuole. So vacuole is very visible in the plant cell. In the animal cell, it is there, but they are very small and scattered all over. Then lastly, an additional thing that the plant cell have is what we call a cell wall. So this is the outermost membrane. And the cell wall, we're going to look at some of the functions of the cell wall in a plant cell. So let's start off by looking at the structure of the function of the cell wall. So a cell wall, it is only found in plant cells, and it gives the plant cell a definite shape and the rigidity. So that is the outermost layer of the plant cell, and it is made of a certain material, a substance which we call the cellulose. So that one is for giving the plant the rigidity and the definite shape. Then the next structure, which is the cell membrane. The cell membrane is found in both the plant and the animal cell. So this is the outer surface, which is very visible in the animal cell. So another name of a cell membrane, we can also call it a plasma membrane. And this one acts as a housing, as a housing. It houses all the contents in the cell. So it encloses all the cell content and separates it from the external environment. Then another function of the cell membrane, it allows the passage of materials in and out of the cell. So there are very tiny pores which are found on the cell membranes. So these pores, they are the ones which allow the passage of materials in and out of the cells. The next structure we're going to look at is the cytoplasm. If you look at the illustration there, where it's pointing, the cytoplasm. So this is a fluid like jelly. It is a place where chemical reactions take place. So this is the site where all the chemical reactions in the cell will take place. And as we have said, it is a fluid like jelly, and it is found inside the cell. Then the next structure is the chloroplast. This one is just found in the plant cell only. So it is oval shaped structure which is found in the cytoplasm. So these chlorophylls contain chlorophyll that carry out the photosynthesis. If you can just jog our memories, photosynthesis, this is the making of food using light by the plants. So the plants make their own food using the light. So this structure that we call chlorophyll, it is also helpful in the process of making food by the plants. So the nuclei is found in both the plant cells and the animal cells. It is the largest structure which is found in both of them. So the main function of the nuclei is to control the activities of the cell. So all the activities that take place inside the cell, they are controlled by the nuclei. Then we have another structure which is found in both of them, but it's very visible and larger in the plant cell. So this is what we call a vacuole. It is filled with fluid which we call the cell sap. You can look at the structure of the vacuole there in the figure. Then we look at the function. So the function of the vacuole, this is just like a storage storage pack. It stores materials such as water, food, nutrients, and waste product. So it's just like a bubble which is found inside the cell, and its function is to store all these materials like water, food, nutrients, and also waste product. So the vacuole can hold the cell's waste product and break them down into small pieces that cannot hurt the cell. So we've said that it holds materials. One of those materials that it holds is the waste product. So it needs to break down this waste product. So it breaks down the waste product and ensuring that it does not hurt the cell. So most of the plant cells volume depend on how full the vacuole is. So the main function is to store material and also break down the waste products which are found in the cell. Now, those have been features that we observe when we look at a specimen, that is a plant cell or an animal cell, under a light microscope. Now, when you come to an electron microscope, it magnifies specimen to higher magnification lens.
For example, it can magnify up to 500,000 times. So it means you are in position to see very tiny features that you are not in position to see when you are looking at the light microscope. So you're going to look at those additional features or the structures that you see when you look at when you use an electron microscope. First, let us start by the plant cell. So the additional features that you are able to see, for example, we have the endoplasmic reticulum. We have the rough and the smooth. We're going to look at the difference and how, why it's called a smooth and why the other one is called a rough. We have ribosomes. We have the Golgi bodies. We have the mitochondrion. And among just the few things that you observe when you look at the electron microscope. Then when you come to the animal cell, there are also additional structures that you see. For example, you can observe the ribosomes, you can be able to see the vacuole, you can be able to see the endoplasmic reticulum, the smooth and the rough. Then there's also additional structure we call the centriole, and also we have the mitochondrion, we have the Golgi apparatus and the chromosomes. So let us look at the functions of these features which you see when you are using an electron microscope. The first additional structure we have is the ribosome. And ribosomes, they are spherical in shape and they manufacture, their main function is to manufacture the protein or to synthesize the protein in the cell. So they are either scattered or they are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. So they are found both in the plants and in the animal cells. The other structure is what we call a mitochondrion, and it is sausage-like structure. It just looks like a sausage. Then it has two membranes. That's why you say it's a double membrane cell structure. We have the outermost membrane. If you look at the illustration there, you have the outermost membrane and you have the innermost membrane. And the inner membrane is highly folded into something we call the cristae. Then it has some fluid inside that we call the matrix. So the reason why the inner membrane is highly folded, it is to provide a large surface area for respiration. And the main function of mitochondrion is to produce energy via respiration. Then the next structure we have is the lysosomes. They are spherical vesicles which contain an enzyme that we call hydrolytic. So it has three main functions in the cell. The first function is to break down worn out cell organelles. So if there are any organelles which are worn out and they're not functioning or they're not doing any work in the cell, it is the responsibility of the lysosome to break down these worn out cell organelles because they're not doing any work in the cells. Then another function is to defend the body against harmful bacteria, as we have seen that they emit this enzyme that we call hydrolytic. So this enzyme will break down the harmful bacteria which they will come inside the cell. Then the last function of the lysosomes in the cell is in the breakdown of lipids and the fats using the same enzyme that is called hydrolytic enzyme. Then another structure found on the cell is what you call a Golgi bodies or the Golgi apparatus. So these ones are made of a series of flattened sac that are closely packed. So the major function is to modifying, sorting and packaging of proteins for the secretion. As we have looked earlier, the function of ribosomes is to synthesize the protein. Now when these proteins are synthesized, they need to be packed. So they are packed in these are like just like containers for package. So the Golgi apparatus are the ones which pack this protein which have been made. So it is also involved in the transport of lipids around the cells and the creation of the lysosomes. So if you can just look at the structure there, the structure of the Golgi apparatus or what we call the Golgi bodies. So we say the major function is to pack the proteins which have been synthesized by the ribosomes. The next structure we have is the endoplasmic reticulum, and we have there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. We have the smooth and we have the rough. So why is it called a smooth endoplasmic reticulum? It is because there are no ribosomes which are attached to it. So if no ribosomes are attached, we say that one is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And its function is to synthesize or to make fats stroke the lipids. Then the rough endoplasmic reticulum, it is called rough because the ribosomes are attached. If you can look at the elastructure, you can differentiate between the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum because of the attachment of the ribosome. So the main function of the rough endoplasmic reticulum is to transport proteins where they are required. So this is a series of events. Like the ribosomes are the ones which synthesize the proteins, then the Golgi bodies or the Golgi apparatus, they pack this protein. Now it is the work of the rough endoplasmic reticulum to transport these proteins where they are required in the cell. And the final cell structure that we have are what we call the centrioles. So these are tiny rod-like structures which are found close to the nucleus, and they occur mostly in the animals. Looking at our illustration, you can see the centrioles. They are very closely to the nucleus, and as we have just said, they are rod-like structures. Then the main function of the centriole is to help with the cell division in animals. So in cell division, they help in the formation of the spindle fibers that separate the chromosomes during the cell division. So their main work is to form those spindle fibers. So that has been our lesson for today, and I'll leave you with these two assignments. Question number one, draw a labeled structure of a mitochondrion. Then part B, what is the inner membrane? Why is the inner membrane of mitochondrion highly folded? And question number two, what is the difference between smooth and rough endoplasmic reticulum in terms of the structure and the function? I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson and learned something. For any questions, feedback, or clarification, you can hit our Facebook page, Elimu TV. Our Twitter handle is @Elimu_KE. Until next time, I've been your teacher, Madam Christine Okoth. Keep it Elimu TV, where you watch and learn.